I'm guessing most of y'all have been to a prom. Some of y'all have not heard, some of y'all are juniors, so. But everybody knows the best thing that's not about prom is the after party. What you do after, that's the best part about prom. So that being said, my junior year, me and my brother got asked to prom, and as you can see by my shoes, I was very stoked and ready for it. And so our plan was, I thought I was gonna tell my mom, I'll spend the night at his house. I'm gonna tell his mom, I'll spend the night at my house. We're half brothers and so. And so we get in the car, we driving to Galveston. We're just driving just to drive, we're just getting head start. We didn't have the address. And so they sent us the address, we found it was 2 hours away. We said, what? Oh goodness, we thought we were driving to a different state. So we get to the house, and then when we begin the house, we open the door, there's a whole bunch of smoke just flying in our face. Probably took like 3 hits. It's like, oh my goodness. And so we're looking around, ooh. And both of us don't smoke or nothing. So we're like, this new us, our lungs are dying. And so we walk in, and there's just girls and dudes, and there's just music going up and down. We're like, hey, let me see a stripper pole. Nice little stripper pole. And we look at each other, and we said, oh, okay. And so I get my wallet out, I said, oh. And out of the darkness, there's a dude running like this. Jumps on a stripper pole like Spider-Man, does a 360, and then falls to the ground, perfect stance. I don't know what to do with that. I think he was ready for that time for his whole life because he was prepared. He was pretty good at his technique. And so we get upstairs, down pack, and then we're just chilling, having a good time. And then as a girl comes upstairs and says, the police are here. I said, huh? The police are here. I said, oh Lord, oh. And the girl's like, oh my God, how they find out? I said, what do you mean how they find out? The whole beach is probably hot. And so, and then me and my brother just freaking out. And then when I get scared, like I get really scared, I get really emotional. And so I'm upstairs talking to my brother. I said, why am I here? I'm a good kid. I don't drink, I don't smoke, why am I here? Why I love my mom? And he looked at me, he said, I don't know, man. And then we're just chilling, and then the girl came upstairs and said, the police said, give him all the weed. And one of the girls said, I'm not giving him my weed. I said, y'all have a problem. And so I'm upstairs chilling. And then a cop come upstairs, he says, you got weed? I said, no, sir. I'll pee in the cup right now. I ain't got nothing on me. And he took my bag. I gave him my bag. I said, here you go. And he took it. And then everybody said, look at anybody else. And he said, anybody have weed? The girl in front of me had some weed, had a whole blender hand, she put it in her butt. I said, oh. And so the cop ran away and said, where'd I put it? She saw my bag. And she said, she grabbed my bag and I was on a bunk bed, right? I swear, I've never been so close to putting my hands on a woman before. I rolled off the bed, flipped my shoe, TV spikes. I lunged at her, I was up there. And she got scared. She freaks out. And then she freaked out, oh my God, where'd I put it? I said, throw it away. And she says, no, I spent $100 on it. I said, what? $100? I said, oh my God, you're sick in the head. And so she, I said, you know what? I grabbed it, I threw it in the toilet, flushed it. She started crying. Oh well. And so 10 minutes go by. I'm just chilling upstairs and I hear Spin Jack. My Spin Jack's my nickname. Everybody calls me Spin Jack. I heard Spin Jack. My brother said, we gotta go now. I said, what? Go now, come on. Apparently the officer told us if the chief come, we're all going to jail. Chief was 2 minutes away. So I rolled the bump bed. I throw my bag, he goes with my cane, we start running downstairs, and then I looked at the man, I said, how good the officer looked at me, he said, oh, didn't even shake my hand. I said, okay. So he runs to the car, boom, I throw him his bag, he throw me in my bag, throw him in the car. Right as we driving away, the girl that drove with us called my name, she said, Spencer. I knew it was real, even my government name, Spencer. I looked at him, I said, yes. And then they said, what about us? I said, what about y'all? And drove off. And I guess the key to this story is don't drink, don't do drugs. I'm going to say the key not to tell the truth to your mom because I didn't get caught, but yeah, don't do drugs, don't drink.